Welcome back, class. I'm at your guide here on Y Caliber. We return to the beautiful planet of Manaan. Manaan. We've got a note from Lana Benico. Well, I would imagine that he doesn't want your services anymore, of course. Too bad for him, I guess. Let's go find Lana and ensure that all is well with the world, and so on and so forth. It always takes some time to get where she is. I mean, it's just over here, though, so it's not too bad. There you are, Cleo. Alright, how's our little gang of conspirators doing today?
You made it.
The way Revan was laying waste to that place, I wasn't sure you'd come out of it in one piece.
But
what
I did.
What are you talking about? I'm hardly in one piece.
You be quiet.
Anyway, my point is, I'm glad you got out of there. Any ally right now is a welcome ally.
We took care of Arcus, Darrick, and their infinite army, but where does that leave us?
It's a good question. Now that we know Revan's in the picture, everything changes. For the worse. In fact, it's already started.
Whatever do you mean?
I'll fill you in, D4. Come on, Jakaro. Let's give him a chance to talk. Lana, when you're done, we can start picking out backwaters to go lie low in.
Oh, you two want to lie low on each other, don't you? You
Some
pervy
good
pervs.
News. I was able to extract a good amount of data from the Infinite Army conscription console.
Huzzah!
Unfortunately, we can't possibly hand it over to our Imperial colleagues. The Revanites have just proven they're everywhere. Jakaro's had 12 death sentences declared on him. Theron's been disavowed by the SIS. And the Empire's placed a bounty on my head for the murder of Darth Arcus.
We need to put a stop to the order, and we need to do it now.
You'll get no argument from me. In fact, Theron and I have been discussing the best way to go about it. The way forward is clear. Theron, Jakaro, and I are going underground. We'll find a way to uncover Revan's plan and stop him.
Right, well...
You can't do it alone. You'll need me alongside you.
For all intents and purposes, you are Imperial Intelligence. The Empire needs you.
I mean, I know it does.
Be who you are. But be observant, and tell no one the truth about us or what you know. Above all, do not try to contact me.
Make this plan work, Lana.
I'll do everything in my power. All our fates ultimately rest in your hands. Remember that.
How could I forget? I am, after all, the main character. We got some glowing crystals. How nice. We got to level 61. How nice. Oh, we gotta go back to our ship. That's fine. I think we can manage. I don't know what's going on with this hood here. It's terribly low res. And it shifts weirdly at the back of the head. But I was getting tired of the other outfit, so I thought I'd try something new for a little while. And this is what I found. Okay, well, let's maybe chat a little bit more with Dr. Loken, see how he's doing.
My good friend, have you noticed that the price of Dianogan tea has risen considerably since we broke the Treaty of Coruscant?
Can't imagine why that might happen.
One of the costs of war you never anticipate. And now my jamming device is working, so we can dispense with the inanities.
You're not usually this cautious. What's going on?
Thanks to a now wealthy Kubaz information broker, I've identified the people who want me dead.
Yay.
They represent an organization called Project Protean, a secret research and development group inside the Imperial Science Bureau.
Boo.
We call the Citadel and demand an investigation. Problem solved.
Black projects aren't so easy to root out, and strictly speaking, I don't have any proof.
So why didn't you leave
Protean
with that?
Protean researches practical applications of alien biology. You recall the genetically modified assassins who came after me? They're only the beginning. Imagine troops spliced with abyssin genes to enhance healing, or adrenals derived from Gamorrean hormones. Most test subjects don't fare well, but you can see the potential.
That sounds awfully like what you were doing on Terrace.
There's a great deal of interdepartmental rivalry in our work, and my research does overlap with theirs. They may have targeted me in order to ensure that they have no competition, inside or outside the Empire.
This is your operation. What's our next step?
Further study, I'm afraid. Right now, I'm unsure where the project is based or how to contact its members. But I wanted to keep you apprised.
Well, I appreciate
now,
that, Dr. Logan.
About that Dianogan tea.
Let's go smuggle some. Of course, by smuggle, I mean agent it.
Hour 36. Subject exhibiting a low-grade fever and elevated N-cell counts. I will proceed to the second formula. Apologies for that, Agent. Bio-experiment logs wait for no man.
Yeah, what can you do?
Going to say what your experiment is about?
Well, I told you about Project Protean and their research into alien genetics. I managed to gain access to one of their databanks. Nothing incriminating there, but I was impressed by their scientific data. I've been adapting it for my own studies into the Rak'Gul virus.
Do I want to know how you acquired Protean files?
They make the mistake of sharing supercomputing resources with other Science Bureau divisions. From there, it gets technical.
Thanks.
In any case, I'm undergoing my second day incubating the newly modified virus. If it doesn't break down my cell structure entirely, I should emerge revivified.
Mm-hmm.
You become a stronger, faster man-eater?
More important, the change itself will be less taxing. It's not unpleasant, as is. But it leaves me with a tremendous headache.
Poor you.
Now, if you'll excuse me, this fever is becoming distressing.
You should probably do something about that. Let's see. What else do you want to chat about?
Agent, you can bear witness. Dr. Loken has agreed to hike Kars Falls with us if we visit the Kars City Opera.
Vector's musical tastes are, frankly, unsophisticated. I'm only trying to help.
Then we have a deal.
Well, that can wait. Right now, there's something the three of us must discuss.
Is it a high five?
Would you care to tell me what's going on?
We're in the dark as well.
As you are both aware, I've been investigating Project Protean, an off-the-books division of the Imperial Science Bureau.
The people who want you dead.
Precisely. Their research is focused on human-alien genetic splicing. I've studied their files, along with your own physiology, Master Vector, and I've come to a conclusion. Project Protean arranged your meeting with the Kilix so they could study the joining.
Oh dear.
Why would they do that? And why Vector?
Thanks to the Kilix, he's stronger, more capable. An ideal soldier or infiltrator.
A science experiment.
For what it's worth, I don't believe it was personal. They wanted a test subject, and you were on Alderaan already.
What do you think of all this?
We think we are who we are. But we prefer not to be someone else's puppet.
Can't blame you there.
They have files on the Kilix. Ways to hurt joiners or to heal them. They may have altered Vector, or simply observed him.
Awful.
I consider it our obligation to find Project Protean and end them. For Vector's sake as well as mine.
You've pulled a lot of data on these people. Finish the job.
It will be my pleasure.
If you'll excuse us, we'd like to commune with the Hive.
I wonder what the Hive is going to have
to say.
Advice,
but I'll give it anyway. Vector knows who he is. Give him time to be sure of it.
All right. We'll deal with the rest of that later. Let's do this instead. Pretty sweet nebula, bro. Said it before, I'll say it again. I love that ship. Hey, it's Lobot. That is attached to his arm.
Hey, Agent. Was kind of hoping to find you in bed. Guess you're busy.
Maybe
it's
next
nothing
time.
That can't wait.
Well, good. Because I did that sweep like you asked. Found something.
Ooh. A tiny radar dish for detecting movement. It's a bug.
What are we looking at?
A homing beacon sends a broadcast, not a direct signal, so we can't discover directly who's tracking us. Transceivers along our route pick up the beacon's signal. If I triangulate the origin of someone collecting the beacon's data from those transceivers...
We are impressed.
Who's following
us? But we don't believe we have ever heard of this planet.
Rishi?
I
know it. Pirates and all that. Never been, though.
Then it's your lucky day, Kalia.
Don't say I never take you anywhere.
We're going to Rishi.
Guess we don't really have any choice. It's off to Rishi we go. This seems to be a planet touched by the shadow of Revan. Lovely. Looks like the planet has a lot of very bright lights on it. Brighter than our natural, even. Even brighter than our unnatural. Super unnaturally bright. Show me what we've got. Here on planet Rishi. See, it starts with R like Revan, so obviously Revan is on this planet. That's just logic, right? Person, lizard folk, some bosks, awful outfits, more terrible hats. Hey, a Gamorrean, who's not holding an axe? Oh, oh. Stop, thief! I guess this bird person is my contact? Rubba lubba dub dub! Ah! A salacious crumb! That they have all these wooden landing pads for spaceships. That seems safe. Sure, have my ship leave me here alone. I guess it's safer for the ship that way. What do we got here? I mean, it seems to be not particularly any better than my current one. Oh, okay. So I lose some endurance and expertise, and power, and alacrity. How does it look, though? It looks alright, I guess. I guess I'll take that one then. So you can only put in a color crystal. Wow. That's more than I'll ever need. Okay. I should have dropped some stuff off in my ship's hangar while I was there. But what can I say? I'm an inconsiderate kind of guy. Oh, that's the wrong mount. But whatever, we're stuck with it now forever. I couldn't possibly change it in any way. I wonder if there are any vendors around here. Not yet, I guess. I mean, it's kind of neat that I got this animal dude, but it's just so ugly. Just mods there. Some common data crystals. I don't think you can buy anything from those until you're level 65, but let's go find out anyway.
The Minister of Logistics is making sure the war effort is well supplied.
Yeah, 65.
Care to take a look at our
ordnance? Level 65.
For the Empire.
Alas.
At last, a worthy disciple.
No, I said alas, not at last. Pay attention. Try to keep up, man. Try to keep up.
I've got good suppliers. Only the best sold here.
I think that one's bound to me. So not too much I can do about it at the moment. We'll just have to stick with whatever we've got.
Feel free to browse.
Which reminds me, I have all these gifts sitting around. Where are they? Coolio would like that.
You know me way too well. You know me way too well. You know me way too well. You know me way too well.
Okay. What else can I grab from here? Imperial memorabilia? I guess not. Why would she want that, really? But I know someone who would want Imperial memorabilia.
Another time.
Order, sir.
Your orders are to accept these gifts.
This is wonderful.
Come on, be a man.
Okay. That was weird. That's the Kaleo voice thingy.
This is wonderful. Thank you.
Sure, anytime. Now let's free up some space in my inventory at least. I still haven't found the scrap peddler.
Signing off.
Bye, Temple.
What's up?
Alright, bird person. Wubba lubba dub dub.
Wow! The rumors were true! You're here! You're really here!
You know me?
Oh, sure. I've heard you described in great detail. Great detail.
I don't like that.
You run the Howling Tempest Gang, the most daring, ruthless pirates of the Gordian Reach. Wherever that is.
That's right. What's it to you?
Just like a pirate. You're all so touchy. I love it. You'll fit right in here.
Seems like everyone in Raiders Cove is going on about you and all your insane adventures. Talk about your tough customers.
I am a tough customer.
Basic. It's very natural.
My people pick up languages and stuff real easy. Some of us like to be formal. I'm more of a cantina talk type. Speaking of cantinas, you'll want to watch for Goro. He wants to fight you so bad, it's not even funny.
What about Kataro?
Tell me where to find him. I'll see he gets what he's asking for.
Goro's at the Blaster's Path. Local watering hole. Probably washing down some Tonitron jerky with some Antellian fungo lager.
Yeah,
not allowed there anymore.
Sure.
Long story. So I hope someone hollows your big fight. Wouldn't want to miss a single bloody shot.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to do that. That makes total sense. Raiders Cove Targeter's Belt. How will that look on me? Pretty good, actually, for being honest. It goes quite well with this outfit. There we go. Okay, so our next step is to speak to Goro, who's all the way up this-a-way. So let's grab one of our mounts and get to work. Obviously, this is my mount for when I'm playing this character of the pirate guy. Look at this place. It's awesome. I love it. Design here is quite enjoyable. I give it a high five out of low five. Not sure why there are two options on my map, when really there's only the one place for me to go, and it's here. Alrighty. I guess we'll follow along this current path and see where that is going to take us. So none of these guys are itching for a battle. So let's not give them one. Now, which way do you think is going to take us where we need to go? And which way is going to be a dead end? Only one way for us to find out. Alright, so it was this way. 50-50 chance, I made the right call. Hey! What are the odds of that? Pretty good, I guess. Everyone got one of these. Here we are. What have we got here? Ah, we've got to go downstairs, of course. Only way to make sure. This place looks very familiar. This is just a reskinned Tatooine cantina. Premium Hyper Battle Versatile Stim. Mastery by 84.
Hiya.
You just say, aye-ya.